From this diagram, we can see Fermat's method. Instead of deriving complicated formulas, he simply listed all of the possible outcomes. In modern terms, we call that defining the sample space. From there, he counted the number of outcomes favoring the first player and the number favoring the second player. The result, 11 for the first player and 5 for the second, matched what Pascal found using his method. Several of Pascal's colleagues in Paris, however, were unconvinced. Gilles de Roberval, in particular, thought that Fermat's sample space was unrealistic. Why, he argued, should the outcome in the first column, 4 wins for the first player, be considered when the players would obviously stop the game after the first player had won the 2 points he needed? Pascal reported that he does not see why one should pretend to make a just division on the assumed condition that one plays 4 throws, in view of the fact that the natural terms of the game are that they do not throw the dice after one of the players has won. To test the objection further, Pascal considered a case with 3 players instead of 2. Suppose, he began, that the first player needed 1 point to win, and the other 2 players needed 2 points. In this scenario, a maximum of 3 throws would be needed to produce a winner. Since there were 3 players, the die would need 3 possible outcomes. Perhaps it had A, B, and C on 2 faces each. This meant that there were 3 × 3 × 3 = 27 possible outcomes. He wrote them out in the same way that Fermat had done with the case of 2 players. A problem is immediately clear. Some of the columns have more than 1 winner. In the 5th one, for example, giving 1 point to A and 2 points to B means that they both win. Pascal decided to split the prize between the 2 winners. Under that condition, for every 27 pistoles of prize money, player A would receive 16, while players B and C would receive 5.5 each. But upon reaching that conclusion, Pascal immediately rejected it, telling Fermat, "We are making a false assumption. That is, that they are playing 3 throws without exception, instead of the natural condition of this game, which is that they shall not play except up to the time when one of the players has attained the number of points which he lacks, in which case the game ceases." Using his own recursion method, he had determined that player A should receive 17 pistoles, with players B and C each receiving 5. Fermat needed to explain the discrepancy. Fermat's next letter came quickly, on August 29th, and in it he agreed that Pascal's division of 17, 5, and 5 pistoles for the 3 gamblers was correct, but he did not go into further detail. He explained that, "The end of the Parliament augments my duties, and I hope that, out of your goodness, you will allow me due and almost necessary respite." He also complimented the treatise on the arithmetical triangle which Pascal had sent him. Almost a month passed before Fermat wrote again, on September 25th, and elaborated on his thinking. "The consequence," he wrote, "as you have well called it, this fiction of extending the game to a certain number of plays, serves only to make the rule easy and, according to my opinion, to make all the chances equal, or better, more intelligibly, to reduce all the fractions to the same denomination. Once one of the players wins, any points the other players win are worthless." Even so, Fermat thought that it was useful to write out the complete set of combinations because it made working with the fractions easier. It also did one other important thing. It emphasized that all the possible outcomes are of equal value. That was the key step Fermat took. Pascal and those who came before him wrestled with the idea that they were predicting the future, something their culture had always said was impossible. Pascal, Roberval, and the others in Paris who read Fermat's letter struggled with Fermat's list of combinations because some didn't seem like reasonable predictions of the future. Why would the gamblers keep playing after one of them had won the game? But Fermat wasn't trying to predict the future. He laid out all the possibilities and then calculated, assuming that all possibilities were equal, how many times each of the final outcomes, each possible winner of the game, resulted.